Welcome to the Spy Collection. My name is Anastasios and today we'll talk about something that we haven't covered before. In several videos we've presented various types of covert listening devices, but what we haven't talked about until today is how Intel officers listen to them. This is our artifact for this episode. This customized rugged Pelican case is a compact, portable LP or listening post manufactured by the American DTC in 2006. Its formal name is MiniMate Digital Receiver, and it was used by several government agencies in the US and abroad when conducting covert surveillance operations. On the rear side of the unit, we have the audio line out, the 12-volt DC socket for external power, like when the LP is in a vehicle, a hotel or a house, and this is the antenna BNC connector. This allows the LP officer to hide somewhere and just route the antenna to an exposed location to receive the signals from the bug. Most importantly, MiniMate-D was able to run on 6 AA batteries, making it a true mobile unit. That envelope probably hints where it came from, but regardless, inside we have its manual, and we'll have a scanned copy of it in the video's description if you'd like to study it in more detail. We'll only read its official description, which was: the MiniMate digital audio receiver's small size and weight make it ideal for most listening post duties, including agent protection and evidentiary missions. Like the original MiniMate, the MMD-1 covers analog FM, both narrow 12.5 kHz and wide 25 kHz channel receiver modes. The MiniMate Digital also adds C4FM digital demodulation, DES and AES decryption capabilities, and analog descrambling. This advanced portable unit can store recorded audio on internal 1 gigabit flash memory or on a standard mini SD removable digital recording card. The MMD-1 is also available with an external digital audio recorder with non-removable media. A removable tactical night light illuminates the operating panel. All controls are placed for ease of use. Signal strength and low battery indicators are also provided. And we also have DTC's Universal Programming Software CD-ROM. This is a Windows-based application written in Java, where the operator can configure settings such as frequencies to monitor, channels, if a bug uses encryption, you can configure its secret keys to decrypt it, and all of that through a USB link. Another software that DTC included was the Wave Checker. That was just adding a small header to the recorded tracks to include some metadata, like recorder serial number, timestamps and recording time. Useful as a watermark, especially if those recordings were going to be used as evidence in a legal setting. That's the tactical night light that the manual mentioned, so that the operator can have low signature in terms of white light discipline. And that's a quick start instructions card. Pause the video if you'd like to read it. Now on the left side we have this small pouch with cables and connectors, just to keep them more organized. Nothing particularly interesting here. And that's the headphone socket, the SD card slot, and the USB to connect it to a computer to program it. Now you see why it was called MiniMate-D, as in digital, because it was software-based, allowing more flexibility than older models. Let's see how it looks when powered on. Its interface is very straightforward. The blue menu defines the overall settings of the unit, like memory card status, mode of operation, crypto settings, and power status. That A is used to select the record device. By default, it's the SD card or external recorder optionally. And B is to select USB access to internal memory. Here we have the audio receiver's controls for volume, squelch, brightness, channel, RSSI and memory. And this is the control panel for the audio captured in the SD card. And we heard your feedback, so apart from just turning it on, let's have a look at its internals. Its PCBs are protected with those shields, but just for the sake of this video, here's how this one looks under that shield. It's at least impressive that what a spy device like this used to do in 2006 is something that today anyone can do with a tiny SDR. It's easy to miss those technological developments when you don't look back, and this is a good example of this. LPs played and still play a crucial role in technical surveillance operations, as they are typically called, and this historical device allows us to travel back in time and understand how that looked like for LP operators in the early 2000s. A small Pelican case for someone's fragile belongings, or a spy receiver. In the world of espionage, nothing's as it seems.